Hello, my name is Gernot Müller-Sixey. I'm a field application engineer here at dSPACE headquarters. And today I want to talk about Linux-based virtual ECUs in software-in-the-loop testing. We've talked a lot about functional testing and software-in-the-loop in previous sessions, where algorithms are running in closed-loop control against a plant model. Most of the time, we think about virtual twins of ECUs in the car, as we know them from 30 years' experience in agile testing, control units like powertrain, brake, stability, steering, you name it. We've also talked about testing simulated networks of several ECUs on CAN, CANFD, and LIN. These ECUs are usually implemented in C, and everything is fixed and determined at compile time. I'm sure by now you're quite aware that with System Desk and VEOS, dSPACE provides a mature platform for integrating and testing such C-code-based virtual ECUs, or VECUs as we call them, and we can rely on the same tool environment that engineers know from Scalexio Agile simulators. In recent years, however, there is a clear trend towards new systems which assist the driver or even take over the steering wheel. These systems have quite different requirements. As a result, classical ECU architectures are not well suited for these systems. Instead, these algorithms are implemented in Linux-based control units. And also networking is shifting towards Ethernet. Of course, these classic, reliable controls will remain and need to be integrated with new systems. Adaptive AUTOSAR is also addressing this area, but today I want to show you how dSPACE is enabling you to integrate virtual twins of classic C-code ECUs and Linux-based virtual ECUs on an Ethernet cluster. But let me take another minute to illustrate how the same applies also to other application areas like Industry 4.0 or home automation. Here too, distributed, often low-level C-code controllers with many I/O are coordinated by a more powerful Linux system on a chip, or even controlled through the cloud. Also here, communication is implemented on protocols based on Ethernet, say MQTT, for example. So to illustrate all this, I've prepared a demo for you today, and I'm taking the example of home automation. So here is a house that needs to be heated. There is an actuator, a heater, and there are sensors that allow to measure the actual temperature and to give a set temperature by a human interface, HMI. All these relatively small components here are coordinated by a Linux-based heater controller. The communication here relies on the Ethernet, and to be more specific, MQTT, and so actually there is even a second Linux system running in the background. So here in Control Desk, I can first of all see some plots where my heater set values and the temperatures are displayed. I have here my heater state with it's active. When it's active, it turns to green, and also a percentage is given here. I have my thermostat that I can control here, and my plant temperature with a decimal point where this is my temperature that the controller sees in as an integer value. Here on the bottom, I have two instruments which allow observing the startup procedures of the virtual ECUs in Linux. I've slowed them down so that you see actually some scrolling effects in the beginning. Also, on the right-hand side, we can trace the virtual Ethernet communication. So with that said, let's start the simulation. We see that these systems are coming up here, and the traces have started. I can now count the seconds here, 12, 13, 14, 15, and so on. And similarly here, now the heater ECU is also displaying a temperature with a timestamp here. On the plotter, we already see that the heater, the green line, is going up to 100% as the expected temperature is 25%, and the actual temperature in the room is 21 degrees. So heating systems are not especially fast, so it will take some time to have the temperature go up. And to speed this up in software in the loop, we can also speed up the simulation itself. To do that, I can activate the VEOS node here, and also go here to my properties, and I have the real-time factor here, and if I set that to zero, that is as fast as possible, then I will see that everything moves a bit faster. I've reached the 25 degrees by now, and the temperature is going to move up and down a bit around the target temperature. Now let's take a moment and see how the virtual ECUs are built. For that, we use System Desk and create a new virtual ECU, a new virtual ECU based on adaptive, that's the AUTOSAR terminology for Linux-based. And instead of adaptive, I will name it Linux VECU. This will give us some folders to start out with. The layers are the file system, or as representing the file system. Here we can insert all those files, or actually tarballs of the file systems that we want to see in the virtual ECU. And on the TCM, we can configure the virtual ECU behavior, especially the timing behavior. For example, every 10 milliseconds, this virtual ECU is activated, and also the networking. Here we can add a new communication node and give it a name, for example, TCM Ethernet controller, or maybe just ETH0 as a hook. And this is the number of the controller, so I could add multiple ones, then I should count up this number here. And I can also assign a MAC address. So now I can add the layers. These layers are regular tarballs that you can, for example, generate from embedded build systems, or, as in my case, export from a Docker. For this demo, I used an Ubuntu file system for my base layer. So if I open the GZ and then the tar, you will see the regular file system that you'd expect from Ubuntu. I can now drag and drop this base layer into the layers folder of System Desk. Next, I will add a second tarball to customize this VECU. This layer contains an init function that will override the Ubuntu default file and the actual control algorithm, which is in my case implemented in Python. So I can set up multiple virtual ECUs here in this way and export the entire file system. With this export, I can then go to my VEOS platform and add these virtual ECUs here, for example, this MQTT server and the Heater VECU. So let me return to my slides for a second. So here I can also add an SSH connection, which is coming from outside of VEOS. It could be also any other tool. And I can access the Ethernet, the virtual Ethernet of such a virtual ECU. And now I can open PuTTY and access this virtual ECU. I will open this and change this setting to the right IP address. So now I can log in. And here I could do anything that you would usually expect from a terminal window and examine, for example, my file system here. So this is just a regular Linux-based machine. Besides this, I can now also influence the simulation. For example, we are currently running here a set point of 25 degrees, and the heater is idling up and down below this. But I could now change this. So for example, a user would want to control this through his web backend rather than using the manual control and override this temperature from the manual control. So there is a small command that is also implemented here that I can test now that will publish to Mosquito, and because I'm actually logged into the MQTT server, publish it to the local host and give a target temperature override of, let's say, 30 degrees. And I will activate the command. And instead of dropping further, the heater is now shooting up again because it's trying to set the temperature to 30 degrees now. We can see that the temperature rises and the temperature is going up. I can also deactivate this now with the same command, but setting it to -1 again, which is the disable override, and the command drops again. So I hope I could give you a nice overview of the features that we have in VEOS available already. You could see how to integrate an Linux-based control unit together with C-based virtual ECUs and to test the integration based on Ethernet communication. So I hope this demo was interesting for you. And if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact us. Thank you and have a nice day.